गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, आई होप यू ऑल विल बी फाइन, सेफ एंड हेल्दी एट योर होम, एंड आई होप यू ऑल विल बी एंजॉइंग योर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस. सो इन आवर टुडेज सेशन आई हैव ब्रॉट द स्टडी ऑफ IUPAC एंड कॉमन नेमिंग ऑफ फंक्शनल ग्रुप एल्डिहाइड. सो लेट मी गिव यू द लिटिल बिट इंट्रोडक्शन एंड आफ्टर दैट आई विल डिस्कस इन डिटेल. Whenever the functional group is having some double bonded and some benzene ring, how these are to be named. Okay, so let us start. This is for aldehyde. Okay, so aldehyde group symbol, this is for CHO, and the suffix that we have to use al, A-L. Okay, and the prefix which we have to use, this is of formyl, that you have to know. Okay, so in the first I will tell the common naming format, and after that I will tell IUPAC naming format. Okay, so you all have to see one by one. The smallest compound, this is of HCHO, we have to call it, this is formaldehyde. For one carbon we use formal, and in the IUPAC we have to use, it is methanol, because one carbon it is to be there and the suffix it is to be of al. Now next it is to be of CH3CHO. Okay, so now in the common naming we have to call, this is of acetaldehyde. As I taught you in 11th standard, for two carbon we have to use their acetal, and in the IUPAC naming this is of ethanol. Okay, now next, suppose we are increasing some numbers of carbon, CH3, CH2 and CHO. So in the common naming that we have to write propionaldehyde. That format will be followed in terms of acid also. That I will tell you in the next video. Okay, propionaldehyde, or we can say this is of propanol. Okay, as you are increasing one more carbon, suppose four carbons are to be there, so that you have to give butyraldehyde. Butyraldehyde. Okay, and next you have to write butanol. Okay, now next, some branching case I am considering. Suppose CH3 and this is of CHO. So this is, the chain is getting branched. So how you have to give the name? You have to write isobutyraldehyde. As I have taught, if the chain gets branched on the number 2, so iso we have to write. Okay, and in the IUPAC naming 1, 2, 3, 2-methyl propanol, this will be the name which we have to give. Okay, now the next, suppose you are having 5 carbon, that is very important. For 5 carbon, the name we have to give, this is of valerialdehyde. Okay, in terms of acid when we will start, so it becomes valeric acid, but you have to know for 5 carbon we have to use valerial word. Okay, valerialdehyde. And for 5 carbon simply you can write for pentanol. Clear? Okay. Now the next, suppose you have aldehydic group CHO, but it is linked with double bonded carbon CH, and then after that you are having CH2. So that you have to call in the common naming acrolein. Acrolein, this is the common name for that. Okay. And in the IUPAC naming, numbering will start from here 1, 2, 3. Prop. Now on number 2 you have double bond, so 2, and en or al directly you can write enol. Okay, I think you all have got it. Another case, suppose you have functional group, now this is linked with double bonded, but its next carbon is linked with alkyl group. Okay, so in that case what you have to give the name? Crotonaldehyde. Crotonaldehyde. Okay, the differences you have to understand. Here nothing is to be there, functional group directly linked with double bonded carbon. Now after that you are putting CH3, so crotonal it is to be used. Okay, and in the IUPAC naming 1, 2, 3, 4, So four carbons are to be there. So you can write but 2 ene 1 al. So directly you can write but 2 ene al. Okay. Next, after that, earlier nothing was here. Now CH3 we are using. After that, you have to use suppose a benzene ring. That is as a phenyl group, and the format is rest is same CHCHO. So in that case, the naming it is to be of cinnamaldehyde. Cinnamaldehyde. Okay, cinnamal word it is to be used. Double bond it is to be here as it is. Okay, or otherwise you can give the name 1, 2, 3, 3 phenyl. Now three more carbons are to be there. So prop 2 enal. Okay, I think you all have got it how to do the naming. And let us talk about suppose you are having the benzene ring, okay, but you are having one CHO it is to be there. So the naming that you can give benzaldehyde, and benzaldehyde you can use as a common as well as IUPAC. In both the cases you can use. Otherwise you can give the one more name, benzene carbaldehyde also, CHO that you can write outside of the benzene ring, okay. Now the next case, suppose you have two types of aldehyde group that are present on their adjacent position. So we have to give the name thalaldehyde, PTHALDEHYDE, thalaldehyde, okay, or otherwise you can give the name benzene, two types of aldehyde group, 1,2-dicarbaldehyde. Completely carbaldehyde will be written in that case, because that is not going inside the ring. Don't write like that benzene 1,2-di, most of the students they do, okay. But here you have to write benzene carbaldehyde, because one it is to be there, because these are to be number 1,2. So you can say benzene dicarbaldehyde, okay. So this is of thalaldehyde, this is very important, okay, that you have to understand. Now one case I am just discussing with you, suppose you are having cyclopentane and CHO, this is coming outside the ring. So in that case, what name is to be given? Only the one name can be given, cyclopentane carbaldehyde. Only one name it is to be possible, because you have to understand, because that carbon is not going inside the ring. Most of the students, what they do, they write the name cyclopentanol, okay. So this cyclopentanol will be the wrong format to give the name to this compound. It is clear, okay. So when aldehyde groups are present on number 1 or 2 position, this is thalaldehyde. And one more thing here I am telling, when they are present on their number 1 and 4th position, this benzene ring, that is, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, number 4th position. So this is of terephthalaldehyde, okay, that we have to use in the term of thalic acid, terephthalic acid, okay, when complete carboxylic acid naming, that is based on that topic, okay, or otherwise you can give the name benzene 1,4-dicarbaldehyde, okay. So that's all for today's session. I hope you all have got it how to do the IUPAC and common naming of functional group aldehyde containing compounds, okay, that's all.